The media is in a frenzy now that Christine O'Donnell is a Republican senatorial candidate for Delaware. Their current goal is to paint her as a nut job, and to be honest, that's not that difficult. She believes in bizarre scientific experiments. She is very hostile to masturbation, which most people consider a fairly innocuous pastime. She hates porn, although as a parent, I can't say I totally disagree with her. And generally, she just seems, when it comes to some of her personal beliefs, to be a Fruit Loop. But the question is whether that's relevant. And here's where I'm going to go into lawyer talk. Many years ago, I worked on a will contest case. A little old lady had died, and she had not left any part of her estate to some distant relatives who were fairly foul and grasping people. As part of their case against her, they charged that she was demented when she wrote the will, and their evidence was the fact that although she knew she owned a house, she was miles off in her estimate of the house's value. She thought it was worth about $100,000, and in San Francisco, you can't buy a doghouse for $100,000. Therefore, they said she was senile. But the fact is, that's not the case under the law. In California, at least, when it comes to writing a will, even if you're insane, as long as you know the elements necessary for a will, your will not be overturned. You need to know the scope of your estate. You need to know that you're writing a will, and you need to know the actual identity of the heirs you're naming or disinheriting under the will. If you're able to fill in those boxes, so to speak, the will stands, even if you think the president is a Martian and the media is controlled by dogs. And as an aside, if the president were a Martian and the media was controlled by dogs, maybe things would be better than they are now. But I guess I'm digressing. In any event, my point is that no matter O'Donnell's rather peculiar beliefs about sex and science, the fact is that Delawareans elected her as their senatorial candidate in the primaries because they believe that she fully understands and will work hard for fiscal responsibility, small government, and strong national security. This is irrespective of Martian presidents, dog medias, masturbation, whatever else you'll have. They think she can do the job, and frankly, there's no reason to think she can't. She may have an isolated delusion or a monomania, but she is fitted for the job she has been chosen to do. Having said that, I'm a little worried, but I still think any Republican right now in this election year is better than any Democrat.